Welcome to the El Harbur Show. I am your host, Luke Harbur. Today I have the incredible Evan. He is my friend as well as an amazing visual artist. Evan, how are you doing today, my friend?
So good, brother. Thank you for having me on the show.
Hell
really
yeah.
Appreciate it.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Yeah. Are you freaking ready?
I'm ready
to do this.
I'm so ready.
Amazing.
So I met him like a few times in the same week. Like I just saw him like 3 or 4 times in a row. And we just became best friends instantly.
The first time I met him, we both set up at as Hobbs Open Studios here down on the West Bottoms, the Hobbs building just a few blocks over.
Our first interaction was hilarious just because I've never walked into somebody else's apartment and it looked just like mine in the sense of his decorations are like either like tattoo stencils or just giant canvases propped up into the wall.
I have spray painted a lot in my life and I've done murals, like hand painted in my life, but I've always loved graffiti culture and street art culture, but I just never did it.
It was literally like a 5-minute conversation. That was the first time I met him. He walked away, but this is the best part about it is that he went to the lady. I didn't realize that he was also another artist. And so he walked up to the lady that was running the event and was like, that girl is underselling her artwork. He was the only person that had bought artwork from me at that time.
I know that everyone else comes into those apartments and are like, wow, this is so cool. And I walked in and I go, ha, yep, looks just like mine. And he was like, shithole. And I was like, shithole.
I think that so many people feel trapped at their job and they want to get free of it.
Right.
You know, they want to kind of move on to what they really want to be doing with their life. It's so hard to find the balance of, you know, having the right amount of free time, yes, money, and energy in your life, I feel
right.
like. And so I'm trying to find the balance between all three. I'm 24 and I'm still fairly young, you know?
Yeah.
And I feel like where I'm at is, or at least what other people are telling me, where I'm at is pretty great as far as like talent and everything. For how young I am, I feel very successful.
So I wouldn't be doing street art and graffiti and murals if it wasn't for Evan. One of my favorite pieces we did was, it's a Bart drinking a squishy of mine and a girl that he did posing with like his name exhausting out of her back, but we just like picked it, did it in like 6 hours, and the colors very much blend together, and we actually used each other's colors so that they like drew it together more and stuff.
I would say like, our first piece, Kanye, we were just excited to just be working on something together and like creating a piece together, and it just totally and wonderfully, like it just came together perfectly.
So it was just like really cool learning next to him.
He's just so, he's got this like essence of magic about him.
Even if we like got into arguments and shit, I don't know, it was always resolved. Like we never went like a full like 24 hours, I feel like, being like mad at each other. And so, because not only because we were best friends, but because it was fucking unbearable if we were mad at each other, you know? Because we lived in 450 square feet.
Like growing up, it was always kind of difficult for me. I didn't really figure out truly who I was until after I moved out of my house. I started working at UPS in the mornings, and I was working predominantly around Black people. Yeah. And so just going through that, like a lot of them kind of viewed me, you know, as a white male. And, you know, throughout my life, white males usually viewed me as Black. So it's kind of interesting seeing on either end how you're treated. This is me, this is my life, and nothing... nothing's gonna change that, so I just need to stay true, you know, to myself and just go after the things that I really want. And so much confidence stems from that too, when like you truly feel like yourself, like nothing can stop you.
His energy and my energy like bounced off very well, and I think we were friends like 2.5 years.
We lived together and worked together and just did everything together, and it just feels like I'm just like waiting for something.
Getting the call from his sister was probably one of the worst days of my life. It was rough. I just wish I would have done more, even though I know I did as much as I could. I just
there was more time.
I met Evan about 3 years ago. Let's see, I want to say it was, I was getting ready for a fight. First time coming up to Kansas City. Came up and I was, you know, the first thing I stopped by and Casey was just looking at art. And a few of his pieces had caught my attention. I didn't even know who this artist was. But later down, my second time coming to KC, they had like this thing called First Friday. And I seen Evan out there painting in the street, you know, and he was just, you know, whipping up a quick piece of art. I was like, hey, man, I don't live here yet, but I'm planning on moving up and I want to, you know, follow your artwork and, you know, push your, you know, your vision out here and what you stand for and your art out here and share it with the world. I moved to KC like, what, June 2018? May, June, around that area. We'd chill every single day. Like, he'd crash at my place, I'd crash at his place. You know, we're inseparable. Well, I'm not going to say it kind of hurts. It really does hurt that, you know, he's no longer here. Us as men, we talk, you know, hold our emotions in, or, you know. So, like, I think it's important for us as men to express ourselves on an emotional level and mental level. I think my main mission now is just to, you know, continue to keep his work alive and spread it as much as I can to the world and, you know, live through that, you know. I'll continue to do that as long as my heart is beating.
I just dream. I dream. Yeah, I have dreams, and dreams is they should be pure. And I think a lot of times, you know, when we're born into this world, we actually wind up going backwards. And it seems like the more we mature, the more responsible our dreams become, and the more governors we put on ourselves and our ability to dream and to reimagine. And it's always a fight for us parents and, you know, for you guys to make sure that your dreams always stay pure. And so it's not a matter of pushing beyond your limitations or expectations. It's really a matter of protecting your dreams, protecting your imagination. That's really the key. And when you do that, then the world just seems limitless. And I made a promise to myself from that day that I was going to work that hard every single day so that when I do retire, I have no regrets. And that was the most important thing for me, is to leave no stone unturned, get better every single day. And if I lived that way, then over time, you know, I'd have something that was beautiful. But that was my philosophy. It seems like a pretty simple one, but, you know, if you live your life to just get better every single day, and do that for 20 years, then what do you have?